Welcome back to another book review. Today we're looking at something from Colt. This is a reprint of Colt Manual number CM102, titled M16A1 Rifle Armorer / Depot Maintenance and Repair Manual, revised January 1980. So we're looking here at the front cover. We can see the Colt logo and the title area and the manual number. Turning over, the back cover is plain, and if we look inside, we can see that this is a reprint from Militaria Press. So that's contact info at the time. Feel free to research current info on Colt and Militaria Press. So if we look on the inside cover, we can see a bunch of warnings already. And then we can go to the table of contents, and it starts off with the chapter 1 introduction, and then breaks down into general description and data. Chapter 2, repair and maintenance instructions, which has repair parts, special tools and equipment, troubleshooting, maintenance inspections. Chapter 3 are repair instructions. Chapter 4, material used in connection with major item. Chapter 5, final inspection. Chapter 6, repair, refinishing, and reassembly. And it continues with the torque requirements, which also has some footnotes there, as well as appendix A, B, and C. A being for armorer's tools, B, replacement parts list, and C, complete numeric parts list. We continue with a list of illustrations, list of tables, and associated manual, which refers to Colt Manual CM101, this being 102. So we can see this will be text, figure diagrams, a lot of data and instructions, that sort of thing. So if we kind of step through, you can see there's checklists and inspections, and then to help with disassembly, various figures and diagrams, charts of steps and various items. Lots of those illustrations. But it's pretty basic. It's a stepwise process. See, I did notice, though, something interesting. I don't know if you can see here, but from pages 30 through 37, there's different paper used in the printing. So the pages 30 through 37 are actually printed on brighter paper than the outer pages. I thought that was kind of interesting. I don't know if that's intentional or if they've some different paper stock got stuck into the print run of this version. But here we have a different style of illustration. So it went from more silhouette and black and white reproductions of photographs to more drawn illustrations. And then it kind of cycles back and forth. So, as you can see, we are now actually in the appendix area, so you can see here they're actually giving you a list of tools and how they should look. Appendix B again was that replacement parts list. So, got your figure number, the page it was on in the book, nomenclature, and part number. It continues there. We actually get into more schematic related illustrations here. You can see, corresponding with assisting navigating through the parts list. Some more illustrations. Depending on which component we're actually looking at. Come on. Nope, it says continued. I can't get this page open. There we go. There's a complicated diagram. Appendix C, we're starting the numerics parts list. Now just continue. So different ways of indexing various components here. And we finish with a look at the armorer's kit. That's something you don't see every day. A little bit hard to read. The print is even smaller than the rest of the prints, so that's kind of like a reproduction. They shrunk to fit. Got a couple pages for notes. And we hit the back cover already. So, again, this is a reprint from Militaria Press. And this is a reprint of Colt Manual CM102 M16A1 Rifle Armor Depot Maintenance and Repair Manual. And again, revised January 1980. This has been another book review. Feel free to check out other book review media reviews on the channel. We also do unboxing videos as well as show and tell videos on vintage MilSERP tools and expanded topics. And we also do a series called Curios for the Curious, videos on more artsy type objects. Feel free to check all those out. Feel free to like and subscribe, and thanks for watching. See you next time.